Please welcome Cuba Gooding Jr. and Adam Graves.
What's happening, y'all? As a huge fan of this game, it means a lot to me personally to be a part of this celebration tonight. I'm very excited to help present these next three very meaningful awards that recognize players for their achievements on and off the ice.
As hard as NHL players work on their game, their achievements outside of the rink are often even more noteworthy. You see, records and statistics were made to be broken.
That's right.
But it's in their communities that players can make an impact that will last.
The crowning of this year's King Clancy Award winner began when all 30 NHL clubs nominated one of their players who they felt best exemplified leadership both on and off the ice, and who also made a noteworthy humanitarian contribution to their community.
And what an honor it is to present this year's King Clancy to the Edmonton Oilers, Andrew Ferentz.
Roll the clip!
Ladies and gentlemen, Andrew Ferentz.
Hey!
Andrew, congratulations, and tell us what it's like to play hockey in your hometown. I mean, that must be cool. Sleeping in your own bed?
Well, I grew up watching Oilers, watching win cups, and it's a dream, obviously, but what a privilege. I mean, to pull on a jersey of any NHL team is quite the privilege, but to do it with your childhood teams, it's amazing.
You were a hero, man.
No, I'm just lucky and very fortunate, and it's been a trip. It's been a pleasure.
I love it. Congratulations again, Andrew.
Yeah. Thank you, thanks to my wife. I came together in there. She's wonderful.
Thanks. Anytime. I'd like to thank your wife, too, Andrew. Thank you, baby. The NHL Foundation Players Award recognizes, they were like, that's why we didn't invite him. Recognizes the player who applies the core values of hockey, perseverance, commitment, and teamwork to enrich the lives of people in his community. The NHL Foundation then donates $25,000 to the charity chosen by the winner of this award.
This year's nominees were Boston's Patrice Bergeron, San Jose's Brent Burns, and Chicago's Duncan Keith.
Duncan Keith! Yes, it's my pleasure to announce the winner of the 2014 NHL Foundation Award, Patrice Bergeron. Right? Patrice! Woo! Now, ladies and gentlemen, you have to allow me for a second. Before we bring up Patrice, you need to meet a dear friend of mine. He is a huge, huge hockey fan who has dreamt for his entire life of only attending the NHL Awards. He is also a cancer survivor. He's also 9 years old. Today, we're going to do him one better. To help bring Patrice to the stage to accept this year's NHL Foundation Award, from Braintree, Massachusetts, please welcome Boston Bruin fans, Will Lacey. Say it real loud right there.
What?
Oh. Ladies and gentlemen, Patrice Bergeron.
Ladies and gentlemen, Patrice Bergeron.
There it is.
Appreciate it, bud. Thanks, bud. Thank you.
Get over here, Patrice. Get over here. Come here, little man. You can stand up there, too. Let's get close. Right. They want us close to the mic because they were too cheap to get the wide-angle lens. So tell us, Patrice, why it is so important for you to give back to Boston.
Well, it's so rewarding, first of all, but also I've always wanted to give back to the community, and that's why I created the Patrice's Palace program. And to be honest with you, I'm accepting this, but, you know, the ones that deserve it the most is the kids, the amazing, the beautiful, the smart kids I've had a chance to meet over the past 8 years. They're an example of perseverance and courage, and they're making me a better person, so I want to thank them all for that.
No, you're doing God's work, sir. You're doing God's work. Congratulations again, Patrice Bergeron. And Will Lacey! Will Lacey in the house! Woo! I know. Control yourselves. For our final humanitarian award, Adam, That's you. I'm very excited to bring out one of your old line mates. Please welcome the former captain of the New York Rangers and six-time Stanley Cup champion, Mark Messier. Mark, tight. Come on, right, let's make a reverse Oreo. Come on, let's do it this way.
Let's do it this way.
That's right. Double stuff. Mm-hmm. Adam, don't grab my ass. Mark, tell us seriously about the Messier Leadership Award. Just say a little something. Get your hand off my ass.
No, it's my hope and belief that the award winner really represents the entire National Hockey League family.
Yes, sir.
And for all the hard work and dedication they have for the game and to make it the best game on earth. And really our best, greatest assets are our history, our tradition, and our people. And celebrating these stories in the way that we have is really important for the fans,
That's right.
Players, and the game itself. So
that's right.
We're very excited.
Well, you're doing God's work too, man. Everybody's doing the good thing. I love it.
Thank you. And this year's winner is Dustin Brown.
Dustin Brown! Because the Kings won the cup, baby. That's right. No, let's take, I know, don't flash it, I'll say it. Let's take a look now at what Dustin has done to earn this honor.
Ladies and gentlemen, from the Los Angeles Kings, Dustin Brown.
I got it.
You sure you don't know?
Yeah, I got
Stanley
it.
Cup's heavier.
It's a little bit. Am I?
Dustin, tell everyone what it's like to play in Los Angeles, because we know how wonderful that is sometimes, and about the great work you're doing there.
Well, I think a lot of people underestimate the fan base we have there. We have a lot of diehards, a couple in the front row here with Eric Stone Street, Colin Hanks, a lot of games, and it's just fun to play in front of a crowd like that, and it's just a fun city to play in.
Well, we love your hustle, man. We love what you all have done, and, you know, going to game sevens and all this stuff and making it happen. Ladies and gentlemen, please give one more round of applause for Andrew Ferentz, Patrice Bergeron, Dustin Brown, and all of the nominees for these very three special awards.